These are free, open to everybody. Your lecture, unfortunately, is a big break with our tradition. It's the first time that the University of Iceland is a party to selling entrance at such a high price. It's higher even than if the Bolshoi Ballet came to this country. And the point my friend was making to Charles, that it does not increase freedom academic or otherwise, it decreases it.
Well, you see, first of all, I suspect that somebody was paying the expenses of those lectures. Who was paying the expenses of those free lectures? The people who didn't go to it. I think that the word free is one of the most misused words. We speak of free education. Education isn't free, it costs money. You spoke of free lectures, but those lectures weren't free. The lectures halls had to be provided. The facilities had to be provided. I am sure you have paid fees to some of the speakers. What you mean to say is that the people who attended the lecture were subsidized by the people who did not attend the lecture.
No.
And I do not believe that that is in my concept of what a free society should be. So I think that the charging of fee for a lecture in order to limit the number to the size of the room, in order to make it available to those who value it most highly, is a perfectly appropriate application of the price system.